Hello and welcome to the next chapter in the journey of Plasfy. And we're looking at Arts 2.0. In this quick video, we're going to look at everything that's included in Arts 2.0, what you can find, where you can find, and how amazing all this is. So at the moment, you can see on the screen, I created a design using all the new elements which are there in Arts 2.0. So with that said, let's go in and find out where all these beautiful images and elements are hiding. Okay, ready? Once you log into your Plasfy account, you go to the clip art section, and here you can see all the new elements. This the Arts 2.0 release is an upgrade over the existing graphic elements that are included with Plasfy, and this includes gradients 2.0, includes new shapes, it includes sculptures. Yeah, you heard me right, sculptures. You get some vintage collection. There's a lot to look at. I cannot cover this in just a few minutes, but what I'm going to show you is an overview of what you can accomplish with 2.0. Arts 2.0. All right, so the first thing we are looking at is this design here, the spaceship, the background fiery element behind the spaceship, that portal looking thing, and the space image. All these were created using elements found in the Arts 2.0 release, and all these are found here on the left hand side. So how are these organized? When you want to pick any gradient or any of these elements, all you have to do is look at the View All menu there, click on it, and you'll be able to see all the subcategories of that category that you selected. Under gradient, we have gradient overlays, unique gradient patterns. These, I'll show you some of these in a bit. Gradient circles, gradient patterns. These are unique and these are gradient patterns. Holographic gradients, mesh gradients, pastel gradients, and pro gradients. Amazing stuff. So okay, so on the left hand side you can see that my view is changing, but that's just a little glitch which is currently being fixed, so don't worry about that. You just need to scroll down. For me, I found a workaround. I just scroll down a little bit and everything just automatically rearranges itself. Okay, don't worry, you might not even see that when you get access to 2.0. you have shapes, you have 3D graphics. 3D graphics are big, they're huge, there's a lot. Okay, so while we're going through all these, and accents is one more that we're going to look at, let me show you some of the designs that I created. I've created about 10 slides of these, and let's see what we have. But look at this design that I created with elements all from within 2.0. So I got about 3 or 4 water splashes, just layered them all together and put the apple in between them and added a background. That's as simple as that. So where did I find all these? Let's scroll down. Let's find the water splashes. So where did I find them? Okay, that's in the effects. Find the effects. Okay, here we go. We have the effects. Okay, and then we scroll down. Water. And look at the water splashes. And different kinds of water overlays that you can use. So many of them. And all that you need to do to create some design like this is to pick different water splashes, overlay them together, as in layer them, put one behind the other, one in front of the other, and this is what I did. I just turned them a little bit. So for example, I added something and I can turn it a little bit, okay, just to give it a different appearance. And that's all it takes. You need the cutout apple or any fruit that you want, water splashes, a cool background, and you're ready with an amazing image. Let's look at another one. Okay, so I played around a little bit with this. This is Mount Fuji, however you want to call it, whatever you want to call it. And yes, that's not real. That's not happening. I added that effect using the explosion effects from here. Explosions. Okay, and we are under effects. I clicked on explosions. This one, I picked this, added it to it, resized it, played around with some effects, as in when I click on, okay, let me remove this. When I click on that, I can play around with some effects. Okay, So I just played around with some effects, blend color and all that. Took a little while, but I was able to do that, and it looks almost natural, right? So that's another beauty. Let's look at another one. All these kind of images are included. The patterned background, that's also there. So it gives you some nostalgic feeling, right? Nostalgic feeling. And have you ever used these things? Yeah, I've used almost all of these. Okay, and then we come to the next big thing, which is patterns. Okay, now take a look at this. Let's look at the patterns here, view patterns. Okay, so many patterns. Now, how do you work with patterns? What I did here on this slide is I added some shapes. So where do you find the shapes? You can go to elements. You can click on shapes. Pick any shape that you want, add it in here. And then, so I have one shape here. So let's click on that shape. Let's go back to the clip arts. We are on patterns. Click on the shape that you want to add a pattern to. Go to the add mask. And then pick the pattern that you want to drag it into that. So let's choose this brown one. Let's drag it into that. Okay, we don't need this, but there we go. Our shape is filled with a pattern, and there are so many patterns to choose from. So many patterns to choose from. So that's another. What else can you do? Okay, we've got a lot of avatars. Okay, so where do we find them? I'll just show you in a moment. Okay, here we go. Avatars, cutout, 3D funky, colorful, cute and cozy, female, and the list goes on. So I've just added some of those here just to show you what kind of avatars are there. Some of these, like this little handsome boy, they come with the background as well. So where's that? Okay, the cute and cozy thing. So take a look. All these different avatars. Nice. Where can you use them? A lot of different places, right? If you don't want to show your face somewhere, this could become your profile image. I don't know. It could be, right? So let's look at another one. Gradients. This is one more big update. And I told you, right? That's the first thing we looked at. Gradients. And all these are created with the gradient options available inside Gradients 2.0. So I added a gradient background. I think it was one of the pro gradients. And then I added this gradient circle. One of these gradient circles, I think it was this one. And then I added a little shadow just to make it stand out. Then I added this text. Simple as that. You got a design ready. And here are some more elements from the gradients. I've got some gradients from the unique gradients pattern. Then this one is from the gradient overlays. And you can go on. Just take time to explore this entire new update, and it's going to blow your mind. Next, we're looking at the accents. This is one big update in 2.0, and accents, different kinds of accents. What are these accents? Just add them in to embellish your image, to make your image stand out, to add a little touch of your creativity into it. Okay, so you've got burnt paper kind of accents. Add them in there to the corner or anywhere that you want as per your design. You've got film effects, different kind of film effects. Then you've got hand drawings, ripped paper, and so on. So many to choose from. Accents is going to become one of your most favorite or most used part of the clip art section. Okay, so I'm sure it would. Okay, 3D graphics. 3D graphics, where do you find them? You go to elements here and scroll down. You can find the gradients, patterns, effects, accents, textures, all that you can find here. But let's look at the 3D graphics and see what they have for us. Okay, thanks to Jasper and team. This is amazing again. You have 3D bay, 3D hands, 3D icons, 3D abstract shapes, 3D Black Friday. Some of these were already there, but then they've added a lot of new things. 3D busts like this one. Then 3D Christmas. Christmas is coming up very soon. You can use some of these from there. 3D cosmic. 3D creatures, then cyborgs and robots. Now all these I've showed it to you on this slide, and definitely go in, test them out. Unless you test it for yourself, you will not know what's available. There's so much. And again, please let me tell you, do not get overwhelmed. So take your time, go through all these elements which are available in the graphic section or the clip arts, see how you can use them. And maybe just let me put in one last word for the avatars. The cutout avatars, these are good because they have expressions, and any of these images can be used on your thumbnails. If you're into video creation, you need a thumbnail, and thumbnails do, those videos which have thumbnails that showcase some kind of expression, shock, surprise, happiness, joy, sadness, whatever it is, your video will do very well. And this is the place where you can come to get all those images. Happiness, joy, different kind of expressions. Put them on your thumbnails and other design projects and just see your traffic blowing through the roof. Okay, so once again, let me encourage you, go in, look through all the elements which we have here in clip arts and elements for you in the 2.0 update, and make sure that you use them in your designs. Make your designs even more fantastic than they already are. All right, so with that said, I'll see you in the next video. More interesting stuff coming up.